There are mornings when you wake up and have no choice other than to get out of bed. And you wish that the sunlight wasn't fighting to reach you from behind the curtains. And you wish you could stop the day before it's begun. But you don't have the strength to fight a routine with bones as sequential as the skeleton beneath your skin. So you breathe in, silencing the air in your lungs, holding it there, cradling its tiny gift of oxygen. And it's the deepness of that breath that carries you through to the place where you work, that causes you to hope against hope that monotonous notes will start to rise up or even fall. That you'll find a virus in the system or a door in the wall, and you'll walk through it and find a world full of people just the same as you. People who are dissatisfied and uncertain. People who would risk everything for love if they weren't so scared of being alone. People who dance close to you at parties with bodies as foreign as the moon. People who are beginning to calculate that life is too short to live boxed in. People who are almost willing to admit that their life just isn't working. And they're starting to wonder if it's the box or them that needs replacing. If they should quit their job and take up painting. If they should make a brave effort to fill the world with colour. Or do something insane like watch a movie with their neighbour. Because you and me, we both know that there are too many yous in vacuum and not enough other people. That community is an anagram for co-mutiny, city, tick and tock and yom, which is Hebrew for day. So let's seize it and show the world that maybe, possibly, there just might be another way.